look at this. Another fantastic morning in Northern Ontario. This is gonna be fun. You know, I was here years ago with Russ trolling in late September, catching walleyes on worm harnesses and different bottom bouncing things. And we're about to do the same thing again, but in early July, you know, show you that you can catch walleyes and pike and maybe smallmouth any time of the year. But we're out here to have some fun, to show you that these Northern Ontario lodges are here to provide for you and I some exciting memories that will last a lifetime. How about we get in the boat, get out, get fishing, and have some fun. Let's do it.
So today we're fishing Lake Metogamy in Gogama area, Northern Ontario. And we've liked using these little Victor spoons for trolling. Put a couple split shots, maybe about 3 feet away from the actual lure itself. And right now we're gonna tip it with half a worm. In the springtime, we'd mainly use minnows, sorry. But we're gonna try fishing with worms today in the beginning of July, so we'll get some.
All right, here was the setup with Ross. First thing, we wanted to just drag and troll worm harnesses. And I just got a 6'6" medium power rod. I got the braid to fluorocarbon leader with a little ball bearing swivel right there. And I'm gonna show you the little setup with the walking sinker, which is a little bit better on sand, okay, to the worm harness. Basically, it's called the walking drop shot and live bait sinker, okay? Real simple setup, but it walks through the sand a lot easier. And then it goes to a ball bearing swivel, but this time I'm using the rolling swivel by Mustad with Diamond Eye. Very unique system, and I'll show you how it looks close up, how you can attach the worm harnesses. So you got different choices. I use the one by Northland called the Walleye Crawler, okay? You can use that. The Lucky Strike as well, simple blade and bead, or the one by Juggernaut in Ontario, where it's a stainless steel little bead with hook with the worm you can't miss on walleyes that are roaming out on the sand.
So when I put the worm on, I like to just feed it straight up the center of the worm, push it on as far as you can, just leaving a little tip out, just so that way they have to really work at it to get the worm off. And plus you get to use it a few more times.
There he is.
There you go.
Oh yeah, there we go. Yeah, right. Oh, he's back there a bit, Russ. Woo! Shaking head, maybe it's northern. The walleyes do that too, huh?
Yeah.
You just finished saying too by this short sandbar. Wow. What do we got here, Russ? Oh, little northern, eh?
Yeah.
Little northern starts our day.
Yep, yep.
I felt a little snap, a little pikey.
There you
go. Whoop.
Come here. There he goes.
There, catch and release. Oh, that's where we started. The one thing with fishing for pike, you always check, because they're little teeth, eh? And I find the little ones are more vicious than the bigger ones, eh?
Yeah.
For teeth. Well, that's how we started. Little northern, and little bladed bait. Let's go back and let's find some more fish. Okay, Russ, if I came here the first time, and I didn't know anything about this system, this lake and stuff, what would be the number one way you would tell me to go look for, find these walleyes with your rental boats and stuff like that too? What technique or what presentation?
Well, we got fish finders on all the boats. So with this being a dammed up river system, there's always that structure from 12 feet to 20. So it's easy to find the drop offs. And if you just do, if I don't tell you exactly where to fish, if you just do some trolling, you'll cover some area. As soon as you get a bite, oh, maybe it'll back up, narrow it down where you actually get that bite, and then you can try jigging for them. It's kind of one of the best ways to
But you find this them. Way we're doing it here, the long line trolling, bottom bouncing is the ideal, right?
I like it. You catch a little better size fish.
Okay, cool. And in springtime, you prefer more minnows than worms?
Yes.
Okay.
Pretty much worms you won't even catch anything on in the spring.
Wow, eh?
I don't know why, but the fish are just like that.
And as soon as it warms up a little bit, you go to the worms, huh?
Yeah, as soon as pretty much the mayflies come out.
Okay. Almost getting eaten size?
Oh, it's eaten size.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Attaboy, Russ. The loon. Oh, yeah. That's the way, man. That's the eaters right there,
yeah,
huh?
That's a nice size.
Yeah, man. Ooh.
That's the size that I like.
Show them what you liked it. Look at that.
Nice colors.
Beautiful too. Just perfect size to munch down.
All right.
Yeah. We figured out slowing down to the jig is the key, huh?
Yep.
All right, let's put them in the box. All right, so we caught a few fish on the harness, but it just seemed like the fish wanted it a lot slower. You know, just had a mayfly hatch here, and Russ said it might be a little bit slow because these fish got a full belly. So we toned it down a little bit. When we saw fish on the sonar, we decided to pick up little ball head jigs. Real simple stuff. All across Ontario, you all know it, wherever you fish. For walleyes, you gotta have ball head jigs. So the pinks, you can't go wrong on a 6'8", 6-foot rod. And then a couple other colors here. Russ really liked the orange. I like the chartreuse green. You can't miss. What I do sometimes, I'll show you a little trick. I've got a little stinger hook that I just put on the hook like that. They're made by my buddy Josh McKay. And it's got a little system where you just push it up against it like that. And now you've got a little stinger hook for those light bite walleyes with the night crawlers or a worm. When they want to hit the back of the worm or the back of the minnow, they get caught with the stinger. There we go. Yep. Doesn't feel bad either. Might be one of those eaters. I'll swing him on top. Oh, he's probably in that range, isn't he?
That's an eater.
Look at the where he got him. You want to get him right like that. That's when you're vertical jigging. When it goes right up and through the schnoz. You see that? I changed to orange. Orange. I watched Russ catching some with orange.
Orange jig that?
Oh, don't do that. And I'm not that stubborn. So, some eaten-sized walleyes we came for. That's what we're catching. There's a Northern Tackle Supply jig. Wow, when it's in, it's in. So, we're catching some golden walleyes from Green Wilderness. Let's put them in the box. Okay, the beauty of fishing up here is we can have versatility. And when you come up to lodges, Northern Ontario, think about the little lead head jig, simple 6'3", six rod, braided line to fluorocarbon line leader, and just basic little lead head jig with either minnow or worm. Find the fish on the sonar and just drop down right to the bottom where you see those little symbols on the sonar. Get right to the bottom, let it go. You've seen it doing this. We've done this a lot of times on a lot of shows. But boy, get to the bottom, get some slack. I pick up, so I'm about 3 to 4 inches off the bottom. And all I do is just shake. I keep once in a while dropping down to make sure I feel the bottom. Lift up and wait till it goes tick, or all of a sudden there's weight. It's great when you can see the fish on the sonar and just pinpoint them. But just being ready. Sometimes trolling, sometimes using worm harnesses. And the good old ball head jig right below the boat.
Some more fish down there.
Is there? Nice.
Oh, I'm getting a tug.
Oh, you got him?
Got
one. Oh, boy. Oh,
it's a nice one.
Is it?
I think it's a nicer one.
Oh. You need Karl to help you here, eh? Where are you?
Oh, no, it's not.
All about the same, huh? But he's gotten on the orange. I don't know how much longer I can keep with the chartreuse. Munched it too, didn't he?
Yeah. Okay, I know you don't like that. It is a nice eater size, but we'll let him go away.
Sure. Now, jigging for Ontario walleyes, real simple things, man. You know, 6 foot, 6 foot eight, 6'6", 7 foot, medium power spinning rod, two piece if you're on fly-ins, to a small little reel. I use a 15 pound gamma torque braid. And I go that to a small ball bearing swivel to fluorocarbon. I use the 15 pound torque to the gamma, 100% fluorocarbon, either 8 or 10 pound, you can't miss. The braid cuts through the line a bit easier, a lot more sensitive, and you don't get those line twists when you use curly tail grubs and stuff if the minnow or worm isn't correct, because there's nothing more frustrating than twisted up line. So the braid to the fluorocarbon, you can't go wrong. There he is. At that time. Yeah, not bad too. I think I can swing him. Maybe let's see. How big are you? Whoa! He's the fryer, isn't he?
Oh yeah.
Oh boy. all through the top. Zap. These are the fryers. That's what we came for. Summertime fryer on the chartreuse orange jig.
And go right beside
handful
French
of walleye.
Fries.
Yeah. Getting bit.
Hello, Tom.
Now we're having to work at it a bit. You know, it is summertime. Walleyes are there, but we're catching some fish. We're putting some fish in the live well. And hey, it's fun times in northern Ontario.
We're not sitting behind a desk.
You got it, man. The little worm in the jig, we went from the trolling to slowing right down. Russ found the fish on the sonar, so we just slow down, pick apart the ones we see, vertical jig, put on the night crawler, and catch them. You can do it too. Let's keep going. Oh. Catch a few more fish. You got a bite there? And yes, sir. How's he feel, Russ?
Not bad.
Oh man, he's doing it. Russ is doing it. We're catching eaters. He said, you want to catch some eaters, Carl? Or you want to catch giants? You know what?
This one,
we catch giants sometimes.
A nice returner though.
Oh, it's a returner?
There he goes.
Okay. All right.
Return to sender.
Return to sender. You know, something about the lodge experience. Yeah, it's about fishing. This is an extreme angler. The chances to go up to Northern Ontario and meet all these lodge owners that dedicate their life for your vacation experience, really. These are memories you're gonna make for the rest of your life. We're not catching any really big walleyes and stuff, but it's the fun, camaraderie, fishing with a lodge owner, a guide, your buddies, your wife, just really special moments, man. And look how serene it is here. There's nobody, serenity. Just you, the walleye, and the little worm on the jig. But it's the whole experience for me, you know. There's different places you can catch different size fish, all kinds of fish across Ontario. When you come to a lodge, just having that camaraderie and the peacefulness, that's why I go, that's why you should go. It is just world class in Northern Ontario. There we are. A little bit of head shake. Let's see what it looks like. Anything? Oh boy, it's a walleye. But I know we're gonna catch bigger this evening. But look, so I'm talking about that penetration right here. Look at that. See that jig? Look where the hook is right through to. Set back hook, nice and sharp. Orange chartreuse. With the fluorocarbon to the braid, to the night crawler. And we'll let him go. Ready? Go on. You just never know how big they're going to be on the hook set. That's one thing about walleye fishing. You just never know. So you're always ready. Drag and drop. Catching walleye. It's that lazy afternoon bite, Russ, huh? The lazy walleye bite. Where evenings are just going to snap it. The line's going to jump. But these, you just got to shake and bake, man. Just shake your wrist. Hardly move it. But bottom contact is paramount. They got their bellies on the bottom here. Wow. This is the between meal bite for us and them. The between meals. We're trying to force feed them. Night crawlers on jigs.
Fish down there now.
Oh boy. Okay. Here come hook sets. Here it comes. Want to see a hook set? Here it comes. Yep. Oh. All a bit better, I think, Russ. Your sonar was not lying, my friend. Oh, yeah. That's one. What do you think? It's pretty close? Or just release her because we're going to catch better?
We'll catch better.
Okay. We'll catch better. You like that, folks? I like that. But see? That's what they look like. Fat little thing when you can barely put your hand around it. You know he's got, Russ has got one. Let's let that one go. Size?
No size.
No size. But they are biting right where you saw them on the sonar, Russ. I'm putting straight down, buddy, okay? Let's just go keep going live. Let's see how many we can pop here. Let's see how many we can pop. Maybe Mama's here, Russ. Mother Nature sometimes can just throw a little curveball. We caught some fish this morning, went in back in for late lunch, and then man, it just came down. Rain, rain, rain. So we're out for the evening bite from Green Wilderness Lodge up here in Gogama. Gonna stick with the vertical jigging, trying to find some fish with the sonar, but on our different, Russ has got an orange ball head jig, I got pink, we've got the braid to the fluorocarbon, same thing you've seen earlier, but now we're gonna have that twilight bite that is so reminiscent and so popular with you people who watch, and yours truly, and lodge owner, and see if we can't put a few more walleyes in the boat on our trip here to Gogama. Yep.
Feel good or?
I probably just like eating size. Oh yeah, look at that, eh? Oh, he got me. Caught a sucker. What do you think? Releaser? He probably is, eh?
Yeah, yeah, you can throw it back.
That's how we start our evening.
We got a couple.
Just a chunky little guy. We got some fish. We're gonna get some bigger ones. Go on. So we started him on 25, 26. Russ says, you know what, we're going to go back to some spots where I got in the evenings where he fished with his wife and send some customers and stuff. So we came out here, started around 25, 26, doing what we're going to do, drop and drag. As soon as that sonar showed fish, bite, fish. So we're encouraged because we always have fun at the lodges with evening walleye after dinner. So I'll get back out, get my Mr. Pink, put it back out, see if we can get some more. Man, oh man. When Russ said, go to the pink, he wasn't kidding. Right away, we went to the deeper stuff and tried it again. Those fish that we saw earlier today were gone after the rainstorm. We came back out in the evening. They were gone. We went a bit tighter towards the point right away. You start seeing the symbols on the sonar, drop down the jig, start catching walleyes.
Something.
Size?
Yeah, it's not bad. It's a nice guy.
Is it?
Yep.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. There you go. That's a nice one.
That was probably in about 10 feet of water.
Okay, those ones are. Show them up on close up inside how he took that pinky. Look how far that jig is in that guy's mouth, boy. Oof. Look at that.
Got it. It's in there pretty good.
Yep. Sitting up on top of the rocks, hey? Russ?
Yep, yep.
Are the ones that are sitting up there. We'll put them in there and I'll try to get a... There's another one, right here. Is he? Uh-oh, yep, it is too. It's better too, buddy. It is. Look, yep, maybe we found the zone, huh? My little brother.
Nice looking fish.
Yes, that one in the box, and then this one, we'll let him go, okay? But we show the guys are right up high, right up on top of the edge of that drop. We re-rig, new worms, see if we can get some more. You know, we came for eaters, we caught eaters. And sometimes it's about the camaraderie, the fun of the lodge experience. Hey, I'm just like you guys, man. I love catching big fish. I love hooking into big walleyes. But sometimes you just gotta take what Mother Nature gives you. There he is. Ooh, he pulled a little. Pulled a little there. Oh boy, he's real close. Now, if we were hungry, guess where that fish would go, folks? Yep. Onto the fryer with the fries, the potatoes, huh? The beans. Ontario at its finest. Go on, boy. Go on, boy. Giving me a thrill. We had a fantastic time with Russ. Caught some nice walleyes. You know what? A lot of times think about that. What's important to you? The great memories and experiences and stuff? That's what happened on this trip. And I guarantee you come to Green Wilderness Lodge, you will experience what I did, catching walleyes, having a great time, some laughs, and I made memories that will last a lifetime in the bank. There he is. Uh-oh, this might be a better. He's pulling some drag, Russ.
I hear the drag.
No, I think he's just, but he would be an eater, wouldn't he?
Well, I think we need a brother in the
okay.
In the live boat,
yes.
Because cleaning one fish just isn't...
Yes, because the fillets on these fish, whoa, stay along, buddy, hold on, are just gorgeous. Handful, thick back, little walleyes, we will have a feed. I'm going to put them in the box. go inside the box. Go visit your friend.
Look inside the box.
So the drop and drag has been working. Mother Nature tried to put a spin into our trip. She couldn't succeed. We caught some walleyes, some pike, had some fun with Russ, and we didn't get any big bragging fish, but sometimes it's about catching the eaters. We caught some eaters. We're gonna make a little shore lunch tomorrow, have some fun with it. But it's just sometimes the experience of Ontario lodges up in Northland. And this Green Wilderness Lodge out of Gogama did not disappoint. Or how can you complain when you're in a place like this, God's country, when you're the only boat almost fishing in mid-July? Thanks for watching, and we'll see you right here, somewhere in Northern Ontario, next time, enjoying the fantastic walleye fishing that Ontario has to offer.